So good afternoon, students. Today I am going to start a new chapter from the book Human Geography, and the name of the chapter is Human Development. Okay, it is chapter number 4. So here we are going to discuss about the concept of growth and development first. Okay, we will be discussing about what does the term growth and development means, what is the basic differences between these two terms, as well as we will also be discussing about the term human development. What do we mean by the term human development? Who were the persons, okay, who came up with this theory of human development that we are going to discuss here? Okay, so before we go to start about the term human development, we start with the explanation of human development. First of all, we should know about the meaning of the term growth and development, because while studying human development, we will be discussing about this, we will be using these two terms, growth and development. Okay, so many of us, we consider both the terms as similar. Many of us, we think that this growth and development are same, they have a similar meaning actually, but it is not so. Okay, the term growth and development is not same, they are different actually. See, so what does the term growth basically means? Growth is actually a quantitative change, okay, whereas development is a qualitative change. Okay, so both growth and development, it refers to changes over a period of time. Okay, so both the growth and the development, it basically refers to what? It basically refers to changes over a period of time. Growth also means changes, development also means changes. But what kind of changes does growth refer to, or what kind of changes does development refers to actually? See, the difference between these two terms is that growth is quantitative and value neutral. Okay, growth is quantitative in nature. That means growth can be measured with the help of numericals. Your age has increased from 15 years to 16 years. Okay, that means it is growth. Your height has increased from 5 feet to 5 feet 2 inches. That is growth. Okay. But your mental capability has developed. Okay. Your thinking power has developed. Your learning capacity has developed. So that is not growth actually. That is development. Okay. So development is a qualitative change, whereas growth is a quantitative change. Okay. The growth can be positive or negative. Growth can be positive or negative. Okay, it may be positive, it may be negative. Like when we were discussing about the term chapter population, I have said you that during the year 1921, India recorded a negative growth of population. Sorry, in the year 1911, India recorded a negative growth of population. Okay, that means instead of increasing, the population growth rate was less actually. Okay, so it was a negative growth actually. Okay, so this growth can be positive or negative, but most of the time growth is always growth is positive actually. Okay, but in case of development, development is always positive. Development cannot be negative. Development is always be positive. Okay, see. So the difference is that growth is quantitative and value neutral, and it may have a positive or a negative sign. Okay, so growth is always it is quantitative in nature, and it can be a positive or negative. Okay, this means that the changes may be either positive, showing an increase, or negative, indicating a decrease. Whereas, on the other hand, development means a qualitative change, which is always value positive. Okay, whereas development means a qualitative change, okay, which is always value positive. This means that development cannot take place unless there is an increment or addition to the existing conditions. Okay, so development is always value positive. Okay, we cannot say that development has taken place unless and until there is some addition. So you just take an example of our mental capability. When we were child studying in 6, 7, 8, our mental capability was less. Okay, we could have learned the short answers and all, but now our mental capability has increased. Okay, we can learn the big answers, we can learn the concepts, definitions and all. Okay, so what has happened is that development has taken place. What kind of development? Mental development has taken place. Okay, so development is basically qualitative change, and growth is a quantitative change. Okay, development occurs when positive growth takes place. Okay, so development may take place when positive growth takes place. Okay, for example, If the population of a city grows from 1 lakh to 2 lakh over a period of time, we say the city has grown. Okay. So if the population of a city grows, okay, population of a city increases from 1 lakh to 2 lakh over a period of time, okay, we can say the city has grown up. That means the city has increased. Okay. Growth has taken place actually. Okay. But however, if the facilities in that city remain same, the same roads, same facilities, same drinking water facilities and all, every same. Okay. So what we will see here is that growth has taken place, but development has not been accompanied by growth. Okay. Means growth has taken place, but development has not taken place along with growth. Okay. So however, if a facilities like housing, provision of the basic services and the other characteristics remain the same, then this growth has not been accompanied by development. That means development has taken place alone. Growth has not been accompanied here. Okay. Yet, positive growth does not always lead to development. So one thing we have to remember is that whenever growth takes place, it is not necessary that development will also take place. Okay. Just remember one thing. Whenever growth takes place, it is not necessary that development will also take place. But whenever development will take place, it is okay. There are chances that growth will also take place. Okay. So yet, positive growth does not always lead to development. Development occurs when there is a positive change in the quality. Okay. So when development occurs? Development occurs when there is a positive change. Okay. Some kind of positive changes takes place in the quality, then only development takes place. So maybe the city has increased in size, the area of the city has expanded, the population of the city has increased. Okay. So what is happening here is the growth is taking place. But if the in the same city, okay, the same facilities are there, no improvement is there in the facilities, so we can say that development has not taken place actually. So this is the basic differences. Okay, these are the basic differences between this two term, growth and development. So till now we had a conception that both these terms are similar. That is why we use the term, okay, as an alternative of each other actually. Instead of using the term growth, we used to use the term development. Instead of using the term development, sometimes we used to use the term growth. Okay. Why? Because we used to think that it is similar. But that is not the case. Okay. And I think now it is clear to you what is the basic differences between growth and development. Okay. So in order to understand the concept of human development, it was very much essential to know about these two concepts, growth and development. So you see here that the term is human development. So what does the term human development means? When there is a change in the quality of life of the people, then only development takes place, human development takes place. It is not said that when there is an increase in the population, human development takes place. It is not said anywhere. But what it is said, when there is a change in the quality of the life of the human beings, human development takes place. So try to understand what does the term human development means. So human development means whenever the living standard of the people increases, okay, their social, cultural and the economic development takes place, then only we can say that human development has taken place. So let us now study about the term human development and who were the scholars who came up with this theory of human development. So for many decades, a country's level of development was measured only in terms of its economic growth. This means that bigger the economy of the country, the more developed it was considered. Even though this growth did not really mean much changes in the life of most people actually. Okay. So from the ancient, last few decades actually, what was the conception we had? That which are the developed countries? The countries which are rich, the countries which are economically more powerful, we used to consider them as a developed countries. But that concept of development was actually not exactly correct. Okay. Because it is not necessary that if the people are having more money, if the countries is more rich, okay, the living standard of the people will also be better. Okay, it is not always necessary actually. Okay, so our thinking about development was partially correct. Okay, because we used to think that economic development means overall development, but that is a partial concept actually. Okay, so not only economic development, but also there must be development in the living standard of the people and all. Okay, then only, okay, the country will progress as well as the people will also progress. Okay. So the idea that the quality of life people enjoy in a country, the opportunities they have and freedoms they enjoy are the important aspects of development is not new. Okay. So the quality of life of the people enjoy in a country, the opportunities they have and the freedom they enjoy, it determines the level of human development. So you will see that there are many countries economically powerful, economically rich, but the people they does not enjoy better freedom. Okay. The people they does not have better opportunities. Okay. The people they does not live a better quality of life. Okay, so we cannot consider that country as a developed. Okay, why? Because the living standard of the people is not so much developed. You just take into consideration some of the West Asian countries actually. Okay, like I have explained, like the lowest sex ratio is there in the country of Qatar actually. Okay, so Qatar is, we can say, economically very much rich country, oil reserves are there and all. Okay, but what is happening there is that sex ratio is very less. People does not enjoy a better standard of life, freedom is limited, basically the female freedom is limited and all. So we cannot consider it as a developed nation. Okay. So there are many nations in the world, okay, which are economically powerful, economically very much developed. Okay. But they are lagging behind in terms of human development. They are holding a very less rank in the human development index. Okay. So this concept of human development, okay, it came into existence during the late 80s and the early 90s. Okay. So the concept of human development was first introduced during the late 80s and the early 90s. That means during the year 1980s and 1990s. Okay. And two scholars, okay, basically two economists, okay, they came up with this theory of human development. First, the concept of human development was introduced by Dr. Mehboob ul Haq, who is an economist and he is a Pakistani. Okay, he is from Pakistan actually. Okay. Whereas later on, okay, Amartya Sen, who is an Indian economist and he also won the Nobel Prize in economics actually. Okay, he modified, he introduced, okay, he added that freedom is also necessary, okay, to live a better standard of life. Okay. So we can see that the two scholars, two economists, that is Professor Dr. Mehboob ul Haq and Dr. Amartya Sen, okay, they are the main, okay, who came up with the theory of human development. Okay, so the concept of human development was first introduced by Dr. Mehboob ul Haq. Dr. Mehboob ul Haq was the first person to introduce the theory of human development. Dr. Haq has described human development as development that enlarges people's choices and improves their life. So what did Dr. Mehboob ul Haq say? He said that development, okay, human development as development, he has defined human development as development which enlarges the people's choices. That means which increases the choices of the people and improve the living standard of the people, improve the life of the people. That is human development. Okay. So people are central to all the development under this concept. And these choices are not fixed but kept in changing. Okay, so he said that people are the central to all the development. Means whatever developmental activity is taking place, it must be for the people actually. Okay, and the choices of the people is not fixed actually, but it goes on evolving with the time, with the situation actually. Okay. So the basic goal of human development is to create conditions where the people can live meaningful life. Okay, so why? What is the main concept of development? What is the basic goal of development? The basic goal of development is that so that the people can enjoy a better standard of life, so that the people can live a meaningful life. Okay. So a meaningful life is not just a long one. Okay, so what does we mean by the term meaningful life? Living for 100 years, 102 years? No, not that actually. Living full life means living a healthy life. Okay. Where we can use our talents, where we can use our opportunities, okay, for getting our like better jobs and all. Okay, where, okay, the people will be free to achieve their goals, where the people will be not restricted, the people will enjoy freedom. Okay, where you can say the people will get access to education facility, where the people will get equal access to resources, okay, where all the people will be equally treated, then only we can will consider that a person is having a meaningful life. Okay, and then only we can consider that human development has taken place. Okay. So leading a long and healthy life being able to gain knowledge and having enough means to be able to live a decent life are the important aspects of human development. Okay, so living a long and healthy life, okay, being able to gain knowledge, that means education, okay, and having enough means, having equal access to the resources are the important aspect of human development. Okay, therefore, the access to the resources, access to the health facilities and access to the education facilities are the key areas in human development. So you may be getting a question, short question, like what are the key areas of human development? Access to resources, access to health and access to education facilities are the key areas in human development. Okay, and while measuring the human development of a particular nation, of a particular place, okay, we take into consideration these three aspects, the health, education and the resources. Okay, so as you all know that a rank of 1 is being provided, okay, means 0 to 1, okay, and the score which a country gets between 0 to 1 on the basis of the score, they are being placed at the different ranks. Okay, so 0.33 for resources, 0.33 for health and 0.33 for education section. Okay. So very often people do not have the capability and freedom to make even basic choices, and many a times we see that the people, they does not have the capability and the freedom to make their own choices. Just take the example of the female child in our country, in the rural area. They does not have the opportunity to go to the education, while the parents, they does not allow, okay, them, because they think that they are there to work for the household. Okay, and if they go for work, the parents, they does not allow them to go to earn their livelihood and all. Okay, because they think the females cannot work outside. Okay. So this may be due to their inability to acquire knowledge, their material poverty, their social discrimination, inefficiency of situation and the other reasons. Okay, so why people are not able to enjoy freedom? Why people are not able to increase their capability? Because they may be unable to acquire knowledge. They may not have equal access to the education facilities. They may not have equal access to the resources. They may be suffering from social discrimination. They may be suffering from inequality and all, poverty and all. Okay, so we need to sort out the problems of this social discrimination, poverty, okay, and all, so that all the people can have equal access to all these things and they can live a better life. Okay, so this prevents from healthy life, being able to get educated or to have means to live a decent life. Okay. So building people's capabilities in the areas of health, education and access to resources is therefore important in enlarging the choices. Okay, so how can we enlarge the choices of the people? By increasing their capability. Okay, by increasing the capability in the field, in the areas of health, in the areas of education and in the areas to access to resources. Because when the people will be healthy, people will be educated and they will have equal access to the resources, then only the people can live a better life, their choices will increase, okay, their opportunities will increase. So if people do not have capabilities in these areas, their choices also gets limited. So if the people, okay, they does not have capabilities in these areas, okay, what will happen? Their opportunities will also get limited. For example, a child who has studied till class 6-7, their opportunities for job is very much less. Okay, a person who is not healthy, their opportunities for job is very much less, isn't it? So we must increase the capability of the people in the health facilities, in education and the access to resources and all, so that, okay, they can live a better standard of life. For example, an uneducated child cannot make the choice to be a doctor because her choice has got limited by her lack of education. Similarly, very often poor people, they cannot choose to take medical treatment for diseases because their choice is limited by lack of resources. Okay, so here you can see, as because people are not having access to the education or access to the resources and all, because of which, okay, their opportunities are getting limited. Okay, so it is very much essential to improve the capabilities of the people in the health sector, in the education sector, in access to resources and all, so that the people can have equal access to all these facilities, okay, and it will help them to increase their capability, to increase their choices. Okay, and if their choices are increased, if their capabilities are increased, obviously they will live a better standard of life. Okay, so this is what about the main concept of human development. Okay, so I hope now you have understood what does the term human development means and what is the basic differences between the term growth and development, and who introduced this concept of human development.